Welcome back with another video of Ubuntu 16, and in this video I'm gonna show you how to do boot in Windows 10 and Ubuntu 16.04. What means, I'm gonna show you how to install Ubuntu alongside Windows if you are an older version of Windows, such as Windows 10, Windows 8, Windows 8.1, Windows 7 or older. And also if you were trying to install an older version of Ubuntu, such as Ubuntu 15.10 and Ubuntu 14.04 or older. Don't worry, go ahead, the procedure is just same for the older version of Ubuntu or Windows. So let's start. Firstly, I'm going to download the Ubuntu ISO file. So open your browser, search for Ubuntu, hit it, go to download and desktop. There will be a link in my YouTube video description, and this is Ubuntu 16.04 LTS. If you were thinking to download an older version of Ubuntu, just hit alternative downloads and torrent. Let's see what's here. So you can find here, download the network installer for Ubuntu 14.04 LTS, 12.04 LTS and 15. So let's go back. I'm gonna download Ubuntu 16.04 LTS, so hit download. If you are not a paid, just click not now, take me to the download, then your download will be start. So that's it. So after downloading, open folder, connecting folder. So what you get here, Ubuntu 16.04 desktop AMD64, what means it is 64-bit Ubuntu. You should download what operating system you have. Let's see what I have. Just right click, then properties, Ubuntu Windows 64-bit operating system, 64-bit processor. So if you get any option for choose B, just choose SMS operating system that you have. So the next thing we need to do is download PowerISO. So open your browser, search for PowerISO, download. Then PowerISO, as I'm using 64-bit, I'm gonna download 64-bit. Show downloads. So after downloading, show in folder, then install it. Yes. Agree, then next. Install. Then close. The next thing we're gonna do is insert our UFS flash drive or pendrive, whatever you say. I'll recommend you to having a flash drive at least 4GB or higher. So let's insert it, then format the flash drive, select FAT32 and OK. After that, open your downloads, then open it with Power ISO, then select tools and create bootable USB drive, then hit OK, then start, then hit OK. So let it work. We're gonna do another thing. Select your computer, then right click right button, then manage. We're going to create the partition for Ubuntu where we're going to install it now. Select disk management, then select your C drive and click right button, then shrink volume. I'll recommend you to make at least 25 GB unallocated space, although I'm going to make 20 GB. So I'm going to shrink to 0240, that means 20 GB, then click shrink. So after making unallocated space for Ubuntu and after USB boot is done, click OK, then close, then P. Now what you need to do is click boot restart. Ubuntu from Ubuntu from the pendrive that we prepared and install it. Now you need to find out the way for get into the BIOS. It can be different for you to get into the BIOS. For my case it is F2 button. This is my BIOS. For your BIOS it might be looks different. Now I have to change the boot priority or boot order. Make USB as first priority. If you got CD or DVD, make CD as first priority, and when you make this, save it. For my case it is F10 to save it. It can be different for you. You should know that if you done this before for installing operating system from USB, you don't have to do this again. So here we have two options: try Ubuntu without and install Ubuntu. As I'm going to install Ubuntu, I'm gonna select install, but if you want try, you can do that. You don't do any kind of change in your computer, then select install Ubuntu. I'll recommend you select both of these, as I don't have any internet connection so I can't select it, but if you also can't, don't worry, just go ahead. Now if you want to select along with Windows, I'll say do not do this, do some advanced way and select something else, then continue. Now the thing we have to do is make 2GB swap area. Click the free space and click plus icon. If you got an SSD, do not make swap area. If you were using hard drive, then make 2GB swap area. Now set size equal 2048 MB, that means 2GB use as swap area, then click OK. Then select free space again and plus icon, then select file system, then mount option forward slash, then OK. After that, device for bootloader installation, select your full hard drive location, click install now, then select your area, then continue, then select your keyboard language,
then select continue. And type your name, your computer name, pk password, choose the password or confirm password. Then select continue. After that, sit tight and wait for continue. After installing, click the restart button. After that, you will see something like that and select Ubuntu and enter your password. This is Ubuntu 16.04. Thank you for watching. If you get any kind of problem or question, you can comment here. I will try my best to answer you.